You're obsessed with the Connie Fife Show. It's about a lifestyle shift to move up or out.
Hey, you want your jam? What's the one thing that really drives you? What makes you unstoppable?
It's about opening a new door to live your dream.
People give up way too early on their dreams.
It's about enjoying the journey. It's about keeping it real.
Damn, now the interviewee is interviewing the interviewer. I like this.
It's all about you.
I knew there was something else I wanted to do. Stop taking shit so seriously. Y'all can do this. Take an outrageous look at life and laugh.
This is the Connie Fife Show.
We love your voice. We love your jam. You need to be on radio.
And now your host, Connie Fife.
Well, hello, welcome, and you're listening to the Connie Fife Show, and I'm Connie Fife, your unstoppable diva. I'm your host and producer, and also the founder of Talent Concierge, where we represent the world's greatest minds. So let's just jump right in, because we have amazing giveaways again this week. My giveaway is just building. We have books, we have t-shirts, we have gift bags, we have surprises, all autographed by our guests. And today we have some prizes as well, and I'll be sharing them with you in just a little bit. But make sure that you are sharing, and that's how you win the prizes. You need to share the show. You need to tag us, and also you need to tag our guests so we know that you're listening, that we know that you're watching, and that you are sharing. Our loyal listeners, I mean, they come back again and again and again to learn how they are building their success, how they can turn their fame, what they've already achieved in their life, into a thriving business. And, you know, y'all can do the same thing. We are sharing that information and giving you those tools and tips every week so you can develop, whether it's moving up in corporate or building that lifestyle business. Because we are all about keeping that passion of life activated and moving those ideas forward. So make sure that you are sharing, share, share. So let's move on to the show. We're going to be talking today about freeing yourself from those crazy making relationships. And our guest provides those urgent and ongoing care for those relationships in crisis. And that's at home and also at work. And she's going to awaken you to recognize and stop tolerating abuse from the relentless, difficult, toxic people that she calls hijackals. Now, I know that you have people around you just like that, whether it's at work. If you are an entrepreneur, sometimes you have clients like that too, and you need to let them go. And she's also an author of 16 books, and she offers practical insights to stop the crazy making. She is Dr. Roberta Shaler. Dr. Roberta Shaler, welcome to the Connie Fife Show.
Oh, thank you so much, Connie. It's a pleasure to be with you.
So when I was looking at your information, I'm like, no, we don't have any crazy people in our life. We don't have any toxic people in our life.
Oh, no, nobody does. Yeah,
right. Nobody does. But I like how you use that term, hijackals. Getting rid of those people, those relentless, difficult people. Mm-hmm. So how did you come up with that term? How did you define hijackals?
Well, great question. And the reason I decided to create a term was I found too many people were going to Google, mm-hmm. and they were putting in what's happening to them. And then they believed that Google was some kind of mental health professional.
And well, they know everything.
Right. So Google's coming up with things like narcissistic and borderline and sociopathic. Mm. Google is an index. It's not a psychological professional. So I wanted a word that people could talk about the patterns, traits, cycles, behaviors of a large group of people, unfortunately large group of people, and getting larger in our world. Mm. And then we could do something about them. But if we separate ourselves by thinking the other person has a diagnosis, we don't get the same results. So that's why I created that term, hijackals, and trademarked it. And here's what they are. Hijackals are people who hijack relationships for their own purposes and gain, and then relentlessly scavenge them for power, status, and control.
So how does someone know that they need help from a hijackal? I mean,
right. Well, great question. Mm-hmm. And of course, that's my giveaway today.
Oh, okay.
Which is my ebook called How to Spot a Hijackal, which you can get at hijackals.com. And you spell hijackals just the way you think, hijackals.com. So, yes, you will know because you are very uncomfortable around them. You are always a little fearful when you're about to interact with them or know they're coming to something or you have to talk to them. And why that is because it's always going to be the fact that they do everything they can to win in every conversation. They need to be right. Mm. They need to have the upper hand. They need to have the louder voice. Mm. You are going to be blamed for everything and nothing is ever their fault. Does that sound familiar?
I probably have five people I could name right
now. That's right. We all have at least one.
Absolutely. So, I mean, and you call it the relentless, difficult people. So what's the difference between that relentless person and just plain old difficult people?
Well, I think we're all somebody's idea of a difficult person on some day. Mm-hmm. You know, maybe we're going through a bad patch. Maybe they're going through a bad patch. Maybe we say something offhand and we think better of it later, but they think we're difficult. That's what life is all about. We go through ups and downs. We're not always perfect. So we'll be somebody's idea of a difficult person on some day. But a relentlessly difficult person is always that way with you. They may not be that way out in the world. It's really important to know that hijackals paint a public picture of perfection while at home creating a private place of pain. So they'll be out in the world looking like, ooh, no flies on them. They are wonderful. They're charismatic and all. People are not recognizing the fact that they are manipulative. They're thinking, oh, isn't this wonderful? How do I get the attention of this person? To be in their aura would be great. And actually at home or in the office or wherever you are closely aligned with them, they're behaving badly. They want power over you. They're dismissive. They're discounting. They're demeaning. They're degrading. Yeah. They simply want to always have one foot on you, ready to pounce, right?
So the I guess the easiest thing to say or the easiest thing to do or advice to give is to say, walk away. What does just walk away from that person, which is great. But what if it's somebody in the workplace that you have to work with every day and they're behaving this way? I mean, how can you stop that pattern of interaction?
Well, you may not be able to stop it. But you can do two things. First of all, you can be assertive. You know, as you mentioned, I've written a lot of books. And one of them is a book called Kaizen for Couples. And in that book, I give all my relationship tips for anybody, couples or not. Wherever two people are gathered, that's a couple in my opinion. And in there, we recognize that to be assertive, you have to know that you deserve to take up space and draw breath on this earth. And then you have to know that you have the right to say what you think, feel, need, and want, as long as you do not mention any other human by name or pronoun.
Okay.
So you have the right to speak about yourself.
Okay.
Here's what I think, feel, need, and want. Not that other stuff that you may have learned 30 years ago, everybody called the I message. When you do this, I feel this way. That's just veiled blame. But you have the right to say, I feel, think, need, want this, and go from there. So in the workplace, you have the right to say that.
So if I'm hearing you correctly, are you saying, yes, this is what I have because of who I am and my place in the world? But would it make sense then to go to the person and just simply have a conversation without blame?
You can try that. And good luck to you. You know?
I know the answer, but I wanted to see what you were going to say. Yeah,
right. You know, I used to travel the country speaking at conferences and do a lot of work in corporations and businesses. Mm-hmm. And so this would come up all the time. And yes, of course, in a normal, healthy, possible place, the best thing to do is to first go to your colleague and have a conversation, right? Okay. To see what you can work out. But if you're going to do that with a suspected hijack call, then you need to be very, very clear that you are taking everything on, that you're saying, well, you know, I feel this way, and I wondered if you felt the same, or I wondered if there was a way that you could we could make an agreement to speak to each other or be in a particular way. Mm-hmm. Now, as I said, chances are not good here because they're going to use that one-on-one time,
right,
to up the ante, to have power over you.
Okay.
But yes, I mean, you can do that if the person is safe in any way, but usually hijackals are very unsafe.
Right. So I'm just getting back to, okay, there's this difficult situation, the relationship, and you're right. I mean, you spend more time with the people you work with than you do with the people at home. So it's definitely a relationship. So now you have this very uneasy, awkward situation. So where do you go in terms of resolving that? Is it just you as a person, you change? Because when you change, people do see you differently.
Well, you changing is great as long as you change into an assertive human being and not an aggressive one and not a passive one or a passive aggressive one, right?
Right. We don't want to be aggressive. Mm-hmm.
So it depends who that person is. If they're your superior, one set of rules. If they're a coworker, another. Okay, so the coworker you may have an opportunity to have a one-on-one with, and you can maybe come away with a truce. But when it is a person who's superior to you in some way or that you report to or whatever, all you can do with them is say, you know, I have difficulty hearing things that feel disrespectful to me. What would really work for me is this. And you just instruct a little bit. And you do it in a very non-emotional way.
Okay.
You know, like, I find I can be more productive when I feel this way. And what keeps me feeling this way is that. And so they can then say, oh, it's completely separate from them as a human being. We're talking about you and you're asking for their help. Then you have an opportunity there. And there are many things that you can do to manage conflict with a superior. But many times what happens, I was speaking at the California HR conference a couple of years ago on this topic. And in the middle of the session, someone put up their hand and said, well, what happens to them? And I said, brace yourself, right? And everybody listened up and I said, they get promoted.
Ooh.
Because hijack calls are like reverse pinball machines in a corporation. Instead of getting shot up to the top and coming down, they slowly make their way through lateral and vertical moves that everybody's trying to get them out of their team or out of their department.
Right.
So they slowly move up the organization.
Okay.
Right. And that's where it gets scary. So you do have to know what you can do and what you can't do, and then what you can accept and what you can't accept.
Got it. Well, let's take a really quick break. And when we come back, I want you to share more about your giveaway and then also talk about the next steps in the hijackal pattern in relationships. So hang in there. We'll be right back.
The Connie Fife Show is heard everywhere. You can find The Connie Fife Show on most of your favorite networks. It's time to now recognize and thank our major networks for all of their support. In the house, we have Conscious Business Radio, C-Suite Radio, Transformation Radio, iHeart Radio. We are also heard on Google Play, Apple Radio, Stitcher, and so many more that I just can't keep up with them all. I'm Connie Fife, your unstoppable diva. Learn more about our gym and how we can work together at my fancy, swanky website, ConnieFifeShow.com. I'll see you over there. Until then, like, share. Now back to the show.
And we're back, and you're listening to The Connie Fife Show, and I'm Connie Fife. Our unstoppable guest today is Dr. Roberta Shaler. She is the relationship help doctor. And then when we're talking about relationships personally and professionally, and she's wrote 16 books, and she's also been featured in Cosmopolitan, The Good Men Project, Love and Harmony, and Psych Central. So now, Roberta, I really like you to share, what are the best steps? I mean, just realizing those hijackal patterns in that relationship that you have, and you want to stop, again, that craziness, that crazy making, as you call it. So in one simple step, and I know you were talking about it before the break, go to them, have the conversation with them. What if that conversation doesn't work?
No, it can definitely go sideways, and you have to get out of there quickly.
Okay.
Like I said earlier, Connie, go for it if you think you can tolerate it. But it's not likely to be successful, but it's worth a try. And why it's worth a try in the workplace is that HR could come along and say, have you tried to work it out? And then you can say, yes, I did. So that you've done your due diligence, right? Before you up level the problem.
Right. Great answer. I know, because I'm just thinking that's what people are saying, but what if it doesn't work? So, okay. Oh my God. OMG, it's time for Straight Talk. So, Dr. Roberta Shaler, I want you to finish this sentence for me. I am unstoppable because
I have a mission, and it floats my boat and flips my skirt and gets me up every morning.
Ooh, I love that. So what is your process for evaluating opportunities? And I'm sure many, many come across your way. So what is that process for evaluating those?
Well, what kind of opportunities are you thinking, Connie?
I don't know. Maybe somebody comes to you and says, here, I have an idea for another book. Or, you know, I mean, the possibilities are endless. So opportunities for business.
Okay, well, it happens. Like this morning, I just got a great opportunity. I've written for a particular company. Now they have a YouTube channel, and they just asked me to do a video series. So what I look at is it on mission?
Okay.
How many people will I reach? And will that be helpful to that population? Right? I want everything to be on mission for me. That, you know, we can get a little too broad sometimes, and we have to keep pulling it in, right? Mm-hmm. And so I evaluate opportunities by visibility and depth of value I can create. So I'm more likely to be invited to be on a podcast, be on a TV show, be a contributor to some website, or I don't do anthologies, but, you know, I can contribute something to a summit or come and speak to a very particular audience who needs my expertise.
Great. So, and you talk about relationships, and, you know, we all know if we have that negativity in our life, it doesn't make for a happy life. And there's so many challenges in the world right now. What do you believe is the world's greatest challenge, the greatest wound in the world today?
Well, I think what's happening is that we've had some influence recently in our country that allows people to feel they have permission to express their dark side. And I think that's an issue right now. You know, that certain things that have been like no-nos are all of a sudden being somehow made into something that's okay. And I think that's a big issue because of the hijackal issue. We are finding in the research that we had a large, significant surge statistically in the number of diagnosed cases of hijackals in the first decade of the century. Diagnosed, Connie. Hijackals don't go to be diagnosed. That means that they had to be court ordered. They went to a hospital. They went to a prison And a few of them may have been enlightened enough to go and actually get a diagnosis. So if that significant increase is in the case of diagnosed people, imagine what it is in the case of undiagnosed people.
I didn't even realize it was a diagnosis.
Well, yes, you're going to have a diagnosis would be narcissistic personality disorder, right. Histrionic, borderline, antisocial, psychopath, sociopath. So those would be diagnoses. But hijackals may not fit exactly the criteria for any of these, but they behave that way because all hijackals drink from the same pool of traits.
Right, right. Well, I mean, and you're right. I mean, the claim is our prison system is overcrowded. Doctors, you can't even get appointments. They're overcrowded. My daughter works with kids with special needs, and she was, you know, she says, she goes, it is just so scary of what is going on. So and of course that could be a whole different conversation. But so for you, so when you're gone, I mean, when you're dirt, what do you want your legacy to be?
That as many people as possible, and I call this the legacy part of my life, so you're right on there, that as many people as possible have been reached by my writing, my podcast, and my YouTube channel, which has now reached over 220,000 views.
Nice.
Know what these signs and symptoms are and what to do about them. How not to be treated like the dirt I've become in your entry. Right. Because they're very demeaning.
Yes.
And sometimes good people, well-meaning people, believe that if only I love them, if only they were loved enough, if only they were affirmed and validated enough, if I were compassionate or less demanding or more loving or whatever, then they would love me. They would change. Mm-hmm. But remember, a hijackal does at the beginning of the relationship, they want to get you into their supply line.
Well, so, you just brought up a good point, though, if I may interrupt.
Sure.
Do they change?
No. No. I mean, a very aware person who was maybe raised by hijackals might say, oh my, I've got some patterns that aren't working, and they might go and get some help.
Right.
But a person who is actually a hijackal by nature, and it happens, the research shows, in the first 24 months of life.
Okay.
So a person who doesn't know any other way to be and doesn't care to learn any other way to be,
right,
that's not going to happen.
Yeah, a zebra doesn't change their stripes, but like you said, if, you know, and it comes from their DNA, their environment.
No, it's not DNA.
It's mostly their environment.
Yeah. Okay. There's only one form of hijackal, a psychopath, that was actually born that way, and you can look at the aberrant wiring.
Okay.
But the rest of them, no. It's environment.
Okay.
Trauma in the environment.
Or trauma that's happening.
Yeah. Okay. They may have some aberrations that come in, you know, various ways that give them a preponderance to accept this and treat this and assimilate and integrate it that way. But no, most of them are the result of their upbringing.
Okay. Okay. Interesting. Interesting. I've done a lot of research similar to this, but it's really, you know, the understanding of why people act and behave that they do. So it's interesting for what you're saying. It's really more around the environment or something, like you said, tragic or an event that has happened in their life. Oh, okay. Okay. So, so what's next? I know you talked about an opportunity that you had today. So where do you go from here? What are your next plans?
The most important thing is keeping the podcast up. It's been on this platform. You know, I have two podcasts. Mm-hmm. It's been on a new platform for 1 year. It was our anniversary last year. They have 70,000 listeners. So that's great.
Yeah.
And I had it going a year before that, but you know, we changed platforms. So continuing the reach, really, you know, this is the legacy part of my career. I want to help people. I want them to see things. You know, I put up videos every day. Mm-hmm. Today, I've done 2 videos already. I have a live stream show every Monday night at 6 o'clock on my YouTube channel. So people can come and ask questions. So what's next for me is keeping all these things going and available. Yes. And that's the way, of course, clients find me and they come to work with me. But I have a membership program for people who want different levels of interaction with me as well.
Okay.
And you find that at optimizecircles.com. Okay. And I have 3 levels of optimized circles. So if people are not ready to work with me one-on-one, then they can join in the membership. And it's safely off social media. Even though I bought software that works just like Facebook, it is safely off. So many of my clients have people who are lurking around on their social media and making false profiles, trying to see what they're up to. So for those people to come onto my site and be safely off social media is a big deal.
That is a big deal. That's definitely, especially with the work that you're doing. And so that's your programming. And again, share one more time about your giveaway and where folks could find that at.
Sure. The giveaway is an ebook. It's called How to Spot a Hijackal. By the time you've read that, you will say, I'm with one. Or I'm close to a hijackal of some kind. Or I was raised by one, because we always have to look in that rearview mirror too, because the impact of being raised by a hijackal is enormous.
I was.
Me too.
Yes.
And an only child. So I got poured on by 2 hijackals, a covert and an overt hijackal.
Wow.
So you find the ebook at hijackals.com, hijackals.com.
Wow. And if you have one of your books that you would like to autograph and send it our way, we could add it to our giveaway. We have our treasure trove.
Sure,
that
I will send you a copy of Kaizen Couple so that you have that.
Love it. Love it. Love it. Well, Dr. Roberta Shaler, I am thrilled that you are here and just proud of the work that you are doing to help people with relationships, because it's a topic that is so needed today in the world. Because again, I just believe one of the greatest wounds that we have is the breakdown of relationships, breakdown of having conversations with each other and understanding that we all do have differences and that we need to accept that.
Absolutely. And I'm 100% behind you there, sister. Let's make sure that we all become more skilled at speaking our truth in a way. You know, I love what John Powell said in a book long ago. He said, the genius of good communication is to be totally kind and totally honest at the same time. Right? And if we could all have that goal, and barring the fact that hijackals won't, but if we could all have that goal, our world would be a much happier place.
Yes, and you can be honest and you can be truthful at the same time. So thank you for being here.
Thank you.
Well, that's all we have for today. I love that you're here. I love our tribe. I love our family. I love our guests. We bring you each week some amazing, amazing guests. And remember to continue sharing the show, tag us, tag our guests. Let us know if there is another topic or an individual that you want to hear from, or if you want to be a guest on the show. Just head on over to theconnie5show.com and we have a form there that you can complete to let us know, because we are here for you. I'm Connie Five and a recovering corporate CEO myself, and we are here and we continue to move ideas forward because we believe it is important. It is strongly important to keep that passion of life activated. Now, if you like what you hear and you want to be seen everywhere, then you want to be advertising with the Connie Five Show. And you can find out more about that as well at ConnieFiveShow.com. So now a word from our advertisers. This week we have the ladies, better known as Jade and Winona, and the We Thought Ladies. They are the publishers of the 25 Hottest Authors, Artists, and advocates, and in their last publication, in the Centerfold. And you want to make sure that you grab yourself a copy. Just go over to andwethought.com to get a copy and to see all the work that these ladies are doing in the publishing industry. And if you haven't done it yet, check out Talent Concierge, because we have the best branding, the best publicist team out there. We work with you. We coach you in business. We have our Masters of Talent Roundtable, and we get you booked and busy speaking and getting some media gigs out there, whether it's television, radio, or print. That is what we do, and that's what we're here working with you on. And you could schedule just a free 20-minute discovery call. Just head on over to talentconcierge.co, and you can find all the information right there to get yourself into our agency. And remember, because we are all unstoppable together, and I'll leave you with this thought for today. And we touched on a little bit today in our show about change and how when you change yourself, you look internally, people will see you differently. And that is the karma, because karma is the universal law of cause and effect, because you reap what you sow. You're listening to The Connie Fife Show. Remember to keep on sharing, and until next time, keep rocking. And know when you change, people around you will change because they will see you differently. Until then, take care. Bye-bye.
Hey, y'all, it's Connie Fife. Thank you for listening to The Connie Fife Show. Check back often. You don't want to miss any of the good stuff. If you like what you hear and would like to be a guest on the show, head over to theconniefifeshow.com to apply. While you're there, check out our amazing advertising opportunities that will put you right in front of your perfect client. I will see you over there. Do yourself a favor this week. Activate your power and be unstoppable together.